Hi guys, I'm Anupa from Geffy Blossom Designs and this is Gigi the Gazelle, a foundation paper pieced block. Today I'll be adding details to this quilt block using simple embroidery techniques. This is the template provided in the pattern. This is what it looks like. All elements marked in black are the elements to be embroidered. Now I can just cut around the outline, place it on the block and just trace out the embroidery patterns. But since there are dark and light elements on this block, I would prefer to do it in parts. So first I'll do the horn area, the facial features and the body swirls. So I'll cut the horn area first. And then I'll also cut out the excess paper around it. Now I'll cut out the inner line here. Now using this bottom line as my guide, I'll place it onto the block and tape it into place. Now this is just some white transfer paper. I'll just place it between the template and the block and then trace out these lines. I'll be marking at the base of each of these lines. I'll move this transfer paper as and when I need it. I'll just lift it slightly and check if the lines have been transferred. Okay, they seem to be fine. I'll gently peel the template away. You can see that the rings have been traced. Of course, you can always trace out these rings freehand also. Next, I'll move on to the facial area. Now this is the facial part. I'll just cut around this edge. Now I'll place it onto the block and tape it in place. Since this section is of a lighter shade, I'll be using a darker color carbon paper. I just slide this carbon paper between the template and the block and then trace out the required lines. Once I've traced it, I'll remove the template. You can see that the eyes and the lips have been marked. Now you can stop here if you want. These are just the basic elements that you can embroider. But if you want to go ahead with the swirls, we'll pick the template again. Now in this next section, there are a lot more things to trace. So in such cases, it is better to strengthen your paper. Also, if you look at the block, it is not a very flat surface. There are like these folds and bumps. So tracing would not be a very easy process. One thing I would advise you is to tape the surfaces where you would like to trace. This will just help you to glide your pen over the template. Now this particular section can also be done in two parts, because clearly you can see that there are one set of swirls on one side and the other set of swirls on the other side. So what I'll do is I'll just cut it in the middle and I will start with this side. I'll start by cutting at the inner line and also I'll cut out the excess paper out. Now I'll align this cut edge along this edge here and tape it in place. Now again I'll take a piece of carbon paper, a dark color one, and place it between the template and the block and trace out these swirls. Now after tracing one side, I will trace out the other side also. Now you can see that I've transferred the other set of swirls also. Now we'll move on to the embroidery part. I usually like to hoop my blocks, not very tight though. So I will push the screw to the end and place the inner ring below and then push the other ring through the top. It's not very tight. If you make it very tight, it might distort the pieces. So make sure it's just right. I'm just tightening the screw a little. I will start with the rings on the horn first. The pattern suggests that we take 6 strands of embroidery floss and use satin stitches to form the rings. So for satin stitch, I will come up at one end of the line we traced and pass the needle through the other end of the line. Now I will come up again right next to the starting point of the first stitch and will pass the needle right next to the end of the first stitch. Again, I will come up next to the start of the previous stitch and come down next to the end of the previous stitch. The first ring is complete. Now I will repeat the stitch to form the other rings also. Next, I will complete the facial features. The pattern suggests to take 3 strands of embroidery floss for this section. For the lip, it's just 1 single stitch. And for the eyes, we have to use backstitch. I will explain the concept of backstitch in a moment. Now for the final section, the swirls, the pattern suggests to take 3 strands of embroidery floss and use backstitch to cover the swirls. So for the backstitch, we have to come up at the starting point from the back and take 1 stitch ahead. Now we have to take 1 stitch ahead from the back and pass the needle to the previous point. We will repeat this again. Take 1 stitch ahead from the back and pass the needle through the previous point. I will cover the rest of the stitches using the same method. Now I'm done with this side. I will cover the other side of the swirls in the same way. This is the final look. I've completed the swirls on the other sides also. Now the pattern also suggests another embroidery pattern, a more simpler one, and the result looks like this. The horn and the face area have the same embroidery as the previous template, but for the body, simple shapes have been used which looks like a V, which you can cover using simple single stitches. I'll show how I covered the neck area for this template. The pattern suggests to take 3 strands of embroidery floss. Now come up from one of the top points and bring the needle down at the bottom point. Now come up from the other top point and bring the needle down again through the bottom point. As you can see, this is a more simpler template and can be made by a beginner also. In case if you like this block and wish to make it, I will add the patterns link in the description below. Hope this video was useful to you, and until next time, bye bye.